So greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Let's talk about mods. So this mod is Doom 3 Absolute HD. It's one of my favorite mods. If you have a good enough PC to run this mod, it's very cool. Let's go ahead and start. Now, if you're wondering, I'm loading this mod only to show you the guns, not actual gameplay. I can't do the actual gameplay because of the gore and the violence that this mod entails. It has a lot of blood spray, blood splatter, and blood effects.
Incoming transport detected.
So, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to initiate God mode. And then I'm going to initiate give all for this demonstration. You'll notice that we got no clip sound. So when the gun popped up, it didn't go click. But you're going to hear why. Here's the new gun sound effects. You also notice no chainsaw. So this is why I wanted to demonstrate this, about how mods are beneficial when the game doesn't age well. And it's beneficial for new hardware because it makes amazing sound effects and amazing new things for your game to experience. This is why modding a game sometimes is beneficial, but sometimes isn't. What's sad now with Doom 2016 and newer is they've implemented some anti-cheat protocols that are not cool, that really kind of make the game a pain in the butt to even input cheat codes into. So now you have to be in this developer mode in order to insert cheat codes. In Doom BFG edition, you have to insert all this stupid garbage startup command crap in order to bring up the control panel to insert cheats. So it's kind of like, why bother? It just isn't worth it in those games when you can sit there and buy the older versions of like Doom 3 on CD or DVD or whatever it came on in your country or region, and then just use a custom mod and have some fun with an older game instead of this newer game. So sometimes a mod can make a game new, and sometimes a mod can make a game suck. It just depends upon your preference. Thank you all for stopping by. Thank you all for coming in to see Doom 3 to mod or not to mod, part 2.